Today I'm going to show you how to create a bootable USB from an ISO image without the use of any third-party software. Now there are other tutorials on YouTube about how to create bootable USBs, but a lot of them will use something like this, which is Balina Etcher. And this tool makes it really easy to do it. It's as easy as the animation shows, but you have to download it and install it on your computer. And I personally like to keep my machines as clean as possible, so I don't want to install third-party software. Fortunately, we can do this from the command line, so that's what I'm going to show you today. Now, the first thing you'll need is an ISO image, and I'm going to use Ubuntu Server for mine. Now, you can select any option you want here, but I'm going to go with the full download. And then once you have that downloaded, we're going to want to open up the command line, and you can just use the start menu and search for CMD, right click and run as administrator. First, we're going to want to figure out which drive on our machine is the USB. So I'm going to start with the USB unplugged and I'm going to run diskpart. And within diskpart, I'm going to tell it to list disk. And you'll see it lists disk 0 and disk 1, and I can use the relative sizes of each of those to see which is which. Now I'm going to plug in my USB. And I'm going to run the command again. Now we have a new disk, and I can tell that disk 2 is the one that we want. Knowing that we want disk 2, we're going to select it. And then we are going to clean it. Now, before you run this command, you want to make absolutely sure that disk 2 is in fact the USB. If you use the wrong one, you can wipe your hard drive and ruin your machine. So it's not catastrophic. You can reinstall the operating system and set it up again, but you don't want to do that. Make sure that you have the correct disk selected. So I'm going to run clean. Now we need to create the partitions for this drive, and we only need one. So we're just going to say create partition primary. Now we need to select the partition. So select partition one. We need to make it active. So we will say active. Now we need to format the drive. So we will say after a few short minutes, we can now assign our USB a letter drive on the Windows operating system. So we just type assign. Excellent. And now we can exit this part. Now we're going to minimize the command line for a moment and find the download of our ISO file. And for me, it's this Ubuntu server. So first we need to mount this onto a hard drive. So we need it to be mounted on the system somewhere so that we can access its files. So you just right click and say mount. So F drive is now this ISO image, and we can see that the USB is G. And we need to know both of those letters so we can do the rest of the installation. Now that our ISO is mounted, we can pull back up the command line and we will navigate to the drive on which it is mounted. And then we want to go to the boot folder, so cd boot. And now we're going to create the boot sector. So we're going to say sect.exe/nt60. And then we are going to specify the USB. So again, the drive letter that your USB has. And in my case, it is G. Now you put the colon at the end, and there we go. The last step is just to copy all of the files over from the ISO image onto the USB. And this command is a little bit complicated, so make sure you get it right. We're going to use xcopy, and we're going to want to specify it as the drive F colon backslash and then star dot star. And that's basically going to take everything from F and move it. Now we need to specify where it is going. So it is going to G colon backslash and slash E slash F slash H. Again, after a few short minutes, all of the files are copied over and our USB is ready to boot. So we are responsible people, so we are going to eject it rather than pulling it straight out of the system like a barbarian. And remember that if this pauses at some point, leave it running. It will sometimes copy a particular file over. You will get a prompt like this one before you're supposed to do anything else, before you're done. So let it run all the way through. It may take some time. And that is how you make a bootable USB from an ISO file with no third-party software.
All right, so we all know how this part works. If this video is useful to you, please hit the like button. It helps me grow the channel and it'll help other people find the video. Also, this is part of a larger project where I'm trying to build a company starting with just 3 old laptops. So if you're interested in seeing how I do that, you can hit the subscribe button and the notification bell to get notifications when I upload a new video. So thank you for watching.